मायसेल्फ डॉक्टर अर्चना चौगुले, हेडिंग डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ कम्प्युटर इंजिनिअरिंग, पिंपरी चिंचवड कॉलेज ऑफ इंजिनिअरिंग अँड रिसर्च. आय वेलकम यू ऑल टू द डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ कम्प्युटर इंजिनिअरिंग. द डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ कम्प्युटर इंजिनिअरिंग वॉज एस्टॅब्लिश्ड इन 2014 विद अन इंटेक ऑफ 60 अँड द इंटेक हॅज बीन इन्क्रीज्ड टू 120 इन द अकॅडमिक इयर 2021. इट इज अफिलिएटेड टू सावित्रीबाई फुले पुणे युनिव्हर्सिटी अँड अप्रूव्ड बाय AICTE. देर आर टोटल 15 फॅकल्टीज, आउट ऑफ विच 2 आर डॉक्टरेट्स, 10 आर PhD परस्युईंग अँड 3 आर ME. वी हॅव टोटल 4 क्लासरूम्स, 8 लॅबोरेटरीज, 1 ट्युटोरियल रूम अँड 1 डिपार्टमेंटल लायब्ररी. वी वर्क अंडर 4 पिलर फिलॉसॉफी विच कन्सिस्ट ऑफ अकॅडमिक एक्सलन्स, प्रोफेशनल कॉम्पिटन्स, रिसर्च अँड इनोव्हेशन and social commitment, which go in hand with outcome-based education attributes, that is knowledge, skill, behavior, and attitude. The vision of the department is to strive for excellence in the field of computer engineering and research through creative problem solving related to societal needs. And we have 3 missions, which on we work on establishing strong fundamentals, domain knowledge and skills. Then we work on establishing leadership skills and team spirit and high moral values in the students and guide students for R&D. As a result of all these things, we have bagged many achievements. Like consecutively 2 years, our department has won first prize in Smart India Hackathon of rupees 50,000 and 1 lakh respectively. Next is the department is at 9th rank in Pune division colleges for the admission, depending upon CET cutoff. Total 27 products are being developed by the students and the faculties, out of which few are websites, apps, 3D printer, timetable announcer, bots, and many more. There are total 7 MOUs under which different activities are being conducted for the students. Total 118 events were organized by the department in last 5 years, out of which one was a world record of filing a copyright of 149 copyrights in a single day. Then 7 FDPs are being conducted for the faculties at national and international level. The papers published by the faculties and the students are total 178. Copyrights filed are 212. Patents filed are 12, out of which 1 is granted. And the books published are total 4. The average placement is 90% in last 3 years and average package is around 4.05 LPA in last 3 years. We have total 2 international placements and 3 international UG fellowships. Thus, the Department of Computer Engineering PCCR has been setting exemplary standards since its inception and is well on course to continue the tradition for years to come. The department strongly believes in its students' ability to leave a global footprint assisted by a highly qualified pool of professors. At department, the teachers are serving dedicatedly to prepare students for a more significant challenge ahead and to nurture them to build a strong foundation for the next level so that they become more useful to the society. It is an honor to represent this department as an HOD and being an integral part of the department. Thank you. This is the department notice board, wherein we have displayed timetable of all the classes, department event calendar, and faculty and student publications, and admission intake. This is program outcome. Similarly, this is vision mission of the institute and the department. POs and PSOs are displayed. This is the faculty list of the department. We have total 15 faculties. Next is Department Advisory Board, wherein we have external academician as Dr. Dhore sir, who is head of department, Army Institute of Technology. Then we have Nilesh Pardeshi sir, an industry stakeholder, who is senior associate, Opus Consulting Solutions. Then we have parent stakeholder as Nandakishore Sharma sir. We have alumni stakeholders as Romit Thite and Pratik Khedekar. And then faculties and students, current students as stakeholders. Then we have Program Assessment Committee, wherein we have module coordinators and department academic coordinators and...
Hi, welcome to Computer Department Library. Myself, Nyaneshwar Chaudhary, I will be giving you introduction about Department Library. So our library is established in the year of 2016-17. Total, we are having 133 books in our library. So we also have entered all this into dead stock register. We also have sample copies of the seminar, also sample copies of final year projects. And also we do have keep record of sample files of the student of each year. About the library process, I would like to share with you that with the help of this library register, particular student when issue the particular book or he return to the department. So that the time supporting staff make the note of that and make an entry on this library register. So this is the overall process. Thank you very much.
Welcome to Total Room. Myself, Mahendra Salunke, Assistant Professor, Department of Computer Engineering. I am also Department NBA Coordinator, Subject in Charge of Digital Electronics and Microprocessor, and Lab in Charge of Digital Electronics and Microprocessor Lab. This tutorial room is of size 36 square meter and equipped with LCD projector and LCD projector screen, desktop, color printer, and having sitting arrangement of around 25 to 30 students. Welcome to E-Shishyakulam, central lobby facility created for computer engineering students. Here in lobby, we made facilities for students to showcase their creativity and staff's creativity. So this model is a model of topology, which is basically designed and conceptualized by Archana Chaugule Madam and Shweta Kopade Madam. And this is the project which is basically developed by Mr. Pratik Valunz, our final year student and his team. Here in other section of lobby, we have a ACM wall and the other models like model of different puzzle games, where this basically facilities provided for students to use these different games. This is the component of network and Ethernet systems which are displayed here in the lobby. This is the cutaway model of computer peripherals. In lobby, we also provided the facility of a television. This is the model of bridges, different hubs. So these models are displayed in the lobby. This is the model of different puzzle games which are displayed here. This is the C-Cube wall where our C-Cube activities, C-Cube is basically Computer Cosmos Consortium, our student association, and their activities are displayed in on this wall. This is the display board which is created and conceptualized by our department faculty members. This is the model of cryptology which is conceptualized by Minal Bodke Madam and Vaishali Latke Madam. This is the model of database management system DBMS, and here you can see the different components are indicated in this model. In corridor, we have safety measures like fire extinguishers. Then we have notice board in the corridor. Then we have the first aid box available here. Then staff toilet and student toilets are there. And the emergency exit is also provided on each floor. And additionally, we have the lift facility on each floor. In corridor, we have displayed list of MOUs, then we have displayed the list of count of workshops and publications done, then results are displayed. This is the department notice board where important notices are displayed for students. We have PCCOE, our ACM student chapter, which is professional chapter, which is formed in 2017. To conduct different technical and non-technical activities. In corridor, we have displayed student achievement boards, scientist boards. In corridor, we have also displayed thoughts on each beam. In corridor, we have displayed information about our distinguished alumni who are placed in good companies, who are working in international companies abroad.
also who got the good packages in Indian multinationals as well. Department tries to connect to the roots of cultural heritage by displaying ancient wisdom in Sanskrit shlokas. In corridor, we have also displayed floor plan of fifth floor. Additionally, we have displayed different technologies in corridor.
Welcome to the programming lab. Myself, Vaishali Latke, assistant professor and lab in charge for this lab. Mr. Ganesh Admane, who is a lab assistant for this lab. And total area of this lab is 80 square per meter. We faculty members developed here two models. First one is a model of 8 puzzle problem, which is solved by 8 star algorithm. Then we displayed here the various type of charts, which are giving us the information regarding the subjects, specific information. Then here we have a one notice board. Such a type of notice boards are available in each and every lab. On this notice board, we display the different types of equipment list, software leads, lab layout, and timetable of the particular subjects. Those are conducted here. So we are conducting here the two practicals. First one is for the second year object-oriented programming, and the second one is the laboratory practice one for the BE. And here the list of assignments, course objectives, and course outcomes are displayed on the notice board. Then the second model is model of shortcut keys. So students are using the shortcut keys in the programming. So we developed this model. Then we displayed here the some do's and don'ts. So these do's and don'ts we strictly followed in each and every lab. We maintain here the date stock register for every lab. Then we maintain the logbook in which students do the signing while entering into the lab. Then we have the maintenance register, which is available in the laboratory. Then we also put the different subject lab manuals in the laboratory. Then we have a different types of programming outcomes. Those are under this lab. So such a outputs are nothing but mini projects, game designing, copyrights, patent filed, projects and models. We have a different outcomes of the programming lab, like mini projects, game designing, copyrights filed, patents, product development and projects.
Welcome to Web Technology Lab. So myself Nilesh Korade, I am assistant professor in computer engineering department. So this is the Web Technology Lab is having 80 square meter area, and there are totally 20 machines, and each machine is equipped with Core i3 processor, then 500 GB hard disk, 4 GB RAM, and 18.5 TFT monitor. So under this lab we have developed different projects that you can see here. This is TechnoVid 2020 website that we have designed. Our student and faculty members have contributed in this website. This is conference on IPR, patent, copyright, innovation and startups. This is 2020 website, which is designed by our student. This is e-learning portal, which will helps to faculty and student members to download and upload their study materials. This is 2019 conference of Indian patents, that is CIPSIS 2019. These are the some our department website, PCCR.com, PCCR Civil, then PCCR NTC, PCCR FE. So each department is having a website, and our student and the faculty members have contributed to develop this website. Then this is e Gram Panchayat apps, which we have developed under this web technology lab, and we have delivered that app to Navalakumbre Gram Panchayat. Then we have designed some consultancy project also. nexuspower.com.in is one of the website which we have delivered to this company. This is second consultancy that we have delivered, mangalmurthyengineering.com, which is a fabrication industry in Chakan, MIDC. We have designed a website for that, mangalmurthyengineering.com. And this is resources that we have purchased, cPanel account we have purchased to host our websites and create codings also. So here we are getting database and some storage space. We have host our all the website by using that cPanel account. This is lab manual for Web Technology Lab. Continuous assessment, for web technology lab. Here is 8 assignments. Then rubrics to evaluate students. Then this is sample student file. This is lab outcome for web technology lab. Here you can see the different projects and consultancy which this web technology lab have delivered.
Welcome to ConceptCom activity room. My name is Gurunath Chauhan, working as an associate professor in computer engineering department. As name suggests, this room is ConceptCom activity. So concept, actually the concept of project execution is carried out here. See here, we have displayed 4 years last project titles with guide name as well as students. So the students who came in 7th semester and they interested to select a project, this particular information will be helpful to them for selecting their respective projects. Here project name as well as guide name as well as student names are given, so that if anybody is interested to do the further work in any specific project, then they can contact to the guide as well as those students for further information. Final year BE project is one of the important activity and which is largest activity in 4 years of engineering. So it is very important to select a good project in beginning. So as a that means the popular phrase, well begun is half done. Generally this particular concept room is used for the students for selecting a good project. So to get the good insight in the whatever the past projects, we display these posters of the good quality projects which have already carried out in last 4 years, so that students can understand in what way they will follow and how they will complete their projects in their 1 year. So these are the few that means project reports and their posters are displayed, and these are available throughout in this particular room, so that students can utilize this information for selecting the good project. Again, this same room can be is used as a activity room, because our labs are occupied with the computers, and here this free space is used for doing various activities. And one of the result or outcome of this particular activity is this robot. The batch 2018-19, one of the group created this particular hugging, that is robot, and this activity is carried out in this room only. So likewise, many hardware related projects like IoT or wireless sensor networks, so such hardware related projects are also created, as well as these activities are carried out in this room. As the name of the lab, activity lab, this spacious table is provided to the students, so that in their free time they will sit here, they discuss about the concepts, about the projects, and the days like engineers day, teachers day, or any technical event. So students sit here and they utilize this lab for various activities.
Welcome to the multimedia lab number 502. Myself, Mrs. Shweta Koparde, representing as the in charge of this lab. I'm working as an assistant professor in PCET's Pimpri Chinchwad College of Engineering and Research, and I'm having total 14 years of experience. Total area of this lab is 76 square meter, and the hardware configuration of this particular lab is there are total 20 computers in this lab with 4 GB RAM, 500 GB hard disk, and they all are fourth generation. Then there are having two printers in this lab. One is color inkjet printer and the other is HP LaserJet printer. Then there is one projector, then one CD writer, one scanner, and there are two different products which are developed under this lab. In this lab, there are three different practicals are conducted. One is second year computer graphics lab, then BE LP1, that is laboratory practice 1, and the second is laboratory practice 2. Assignment list and the course outcome of this lab is displayed on this notice board for the reference. The outcome of this lab, that is second year computer graphics lab, is the mini project which is developed by the students, and we have shown it on the monitor for the reference. In every lab, we are maintaining the attendance register, then the lab manual and the preventive maintenance register as well as the dead stock. So, as our institute is the ISO certified institute, so we are maintaining the preventive maintenance register in every lab. Now, under this preventive maintenance register, there is some ACAD format which we are maintaining. So, CPU cleaning and checking procedure, it will be done per month, in once in a month, and then monitor, keyboard and mouse cleaning procedure, it is also done per month, once in a month and as per requirement, and full formatting and the installation is done at the end of every semester as well as per the requirement. Outcome of the multimedia lab is we have developed three products under this lab. So, first product is the model of multimedia tools, where we have displayed all the models which can be used in a multimedia lab, like smartphone is there, then music castle is there, dynamic microphone is there, gamepad, then headset with mic. Like this, all the tools have been developed and they are displayed on the this particular model. Also, our second model which we have developed is the RGB color model. So, RGB color model, as the name itself suggests, the additive color, that is the main color, red, green and blue, they are displayed, and they are the outcome of the RGB color model is nothing but it is used in the electronic devices like computers, then television. Also, in this lab, we have displayed the different charts for the student reference, like color model is there, then the conversion of color models from one color model to the other. Under project based learning, we have developed one model in this lab, that is smart door lock system, where the students have used the RFID scanner as well as the keypad to open the door of this particular lab. So, under multimedia lab, the outcome of this lab is the student have developed the 34 mini projects, some games, then 12 copyrights has been filed under the project based learning, 2 patents have been filed by myself, and 6 projects I have guided, and 3 products have been developed in the multimedia lab.
Welcome to Digital Electronics and Microprocessor Lab. In this lab, we are conducting practicals of digital electronics and microprocessor lab. This lab is equipped with 22 latest machines, LCD projector, then there are cut section models which are available. On notice board, we have displayed all software list, equipment list, timetable, then course outcomes of all the subjects are displayed here. And program outcomes are also displayed on notice board, and the list of assignments are displayed on the notice board. In this lab, we have displayed the board of different embedded devices. We have displayed the block diagram of architectures of different microprocessor. These are the cut section models which we have developed in association with the industry. These are the digital trainer kits. These are the data storage devices models which is developed. Then this is the model of heat sink, PC repair kit, connectors and cables. This is the model of basic computer hardware, where we can see different components of microprocessor. Or this is the study of basic electronics component, where different components are displayed. And these are the different models of microprocessor and microcontrollers. And the digital trainer kit is also available in this particular lab. This is the 3D printer which is developed by Mr. Pratik, our BE student. This project is 100% funded by college. So, I request Pratik to give information about the 3D printer.
So, this is 3D printer which works on fused decomposition modeling technique, and it has the size of printing size of 200 by 200 by 230 mm, and it works on the microcontroller which is of 32 bit, and the nozzle temperature goes up to 230 degrees Celsius, and it has stepper motors for controlling all the movements of all three axes. So now this is it is printing up a 3D model. So it takes near about 6 hours to print.
These are the products which are developed under Digital Electronics and Microprocessor Laboratory, where we developed 3D printer, we have developed kiosk for library, we have developed rolling display, then 8-bit microcontroller microprocessor was developed, then cut section models of UPS and the SMPS was developed,
So we have developed a project simulation of shortest path, and different models of different products are also developed under this lab. This lab is also a FOS center, which is established in collaboration with Spoken Tutorial IIT Bombay in 2017.
Welcome to Database Management Systems Lab. I myself, Sonali Lunawat, am working as an assistant professor in Department of Computer Engineering, and I am lab in charge for this lab. This is the system which is developed by students, which is an uploading system. Whenever practical exams are there, students upload their programs here, and in the system used a PHP script, and as a backend MySQL software has been used. This is another project which is developed by students. It is a Phoenix app, which is freely available for all the rural people, and this is a playful manner students can understand English grammars, and these many features are there, and this project has been built by React.js and backend has used as Firebase. So this is another project which have built by students, and it is for online examination. It's called as ExamBus software, wherein faculties create some test and students give that test. So this chart shows what is different types of data structures, that is linear and non-linear. This chart explains what is data warehouse architecture and what is the big data concept. This chart shows what is the difference between SQL and NoSQL database and architecture of DBMS. And this shows the overall database internal architecture. These are the different outcomes of Database Management Lab. 5 products are developed. There are for placements, many feedbacks are received by students. 5 students have qualified GATE, 2 have registered for copyright, and we have helped for society. We have created MSCET online app, and 35 NPTEL certifications have been done. Models were developed, and 50 mini projects have been done till date. We have an MOU with Zensar RPG Foundations, where n number of activities, that is Zensar ESD trainings, have been carried, and many of students have benefited by it in their placement activities.
Hi, myself Nyaneshwar Chaudhary. I am the lab in charge of this computer network lab. So basically, in this lab, we have 2 types of practical. One is CN lab and second one is ESIoT lab. So these are the pretty much requirement and install softwares in this lab. So as you can see, in this software list, we have installed total 8 softwares, which are needed for computer network as well as ESIoT.
So this is one of the mini project developed by the student under this lab. So this project tells us that importance of the avoiding air pollution. So here you can see we have used gas sensor, alarm, as well as LEDs, which shows us when there is a higher side of pollution, it shows the notification and alarm buzzer will be alarmed. Second thing, if there is a lower side of air pollution, or like there will be no air pollution, so green light will be there and no notification form like from the buzzer will come. Only on the LED it will show there is a percentage of pollution will be low.
So this computer network lab have total 66 square meter area, and as you can see, this is a computer department network overview. Here you can see all the labs available and their network connectivity with the central switch. Hi. So for the safety precaution, as we know, there is a in any infrastructure, network is one of the important pillar. So to maintain our network and to maintain all the connectivity in between the department, we have this network switch. Okay, it is having 24 and 48 ports inside it, this particular lab. It helps us to maintain our network infrastructure. Thank you. Under second precaution, here you can see we have this MCB and also plastic coating to the wire. So both of these things help us to save from the electricity. How? With the help of this plastic coating, we can prevent the shock which will be affect students or faculties. And there is a MCB. This MCB plays role by cutting the whole lab electricity whenever there is a short circuit of the light. So here is a third precaution under the lab. There is a CCTV. So our each and every lab is under surveillance of CCTV by 24/7. Here we can manage the all the activities, or we can track the activities which is happening under the each lab. Under the precaution, next thing is that we are using the Sophos firewall and credentials for the each user to use the internet, so that it can avoid unwanted and unauthorized access from the web. So this is the outcome of the computer network lab. As you can see, students have developed some mini projects with the help of the IoT kits, and these are the product developed by the faculties. First one is the developed algorithm, that is a cryptology algorithm, and second developed infrastructure, that is a something called as the network topologies. This is the one of the MOU sanctioned under this lab, which has been sanctioned with the SK Diptech Private Limited company, which is a basically Chennai based company, which trains students on the machine learning and AI and all those things related to the current technology. This is the overall banner of the C Cube. Basically, C Cube is a student, basically it's a I will say a club which helps student to develop their skill set and their mindset about the soft skills.
Welcome to Project and Research Lab. Myself, Professor Jameer Kotwal, assistant professor and also in charge of this lab. With me, my supportive staff member, Mr. Ganesh Admani sir, is also there. The notice board is there with the course objective for a project stage 1 as well as for a project stage 2. List of hardware equipments and the software equipments which is there in this project lab. And here some of the models, images we have shown. List of the projects with copyright details and the patent, also the publication. So all the details we have displayed on a notice board. The area of the project lab is 76 square meter, along with 22 highly equipped systems having the configuration of Core i5 with 8 GB RAM and 1 TB hard disk. Along with these 22 systems, we are having the two workstations, that is Dell and Intel Xeon. Here are some final year project students poster displayed. First, the first one is about hugging robot for analyzing the human behavior. Next is warehouse automation systems, which is basically used to minimize the warehouse utilization and task. Next poster is vehicle emergency detection and tracking using the smartphone's integrated sensor. It is basically used for the emergency. And the last poster is a smart control systems in automobile. Most of the projects are in the various domain, that is machine learning, deep learning, IoT, and also the AR VR projects are also done by the students. So here is the Oculus headset which has been provided to execute their AR VR projects. The outcome of this project and research lab is near about 70 plus publication is done by the students with 47 copyright, 1 patent. And some of the products is developed by the students, and also the students are participating in various state level competitions. This lab is sponsored by a company, that is ZenStack Solution India Private Limited.
Welcome to classroom of Computer Engineering Department. This classroom is of 76 square meter, and all classrooms are equipped with desktop machines, smart board, LCD projector, and having size of 76 square meter. This facility is well ventilated and having proper natural light in the classroom.
Thank you for being with us on this virtual tour of Department of Computer Engineering. Thank you.